Hey, what's up, guys? Kool-Aid here. Got some Marvel Heroes gameplay for you today. This is a video that I've been wanting to do for a while. I've actually mentioned it in the past. Marvel Heroes is a game that I've been playing since its release about 2 years ago, and the two-year anniversary is coming up, which is why I felt I should do this video right now, because if you do want to jump into this game and try it out, they will offer some good deals coming up with that two-year anniversary, because it is a free-to-play game, and I'll talk more about the free-to-play model in just a minute. But the main reason I'm doing this video is because I think the game deserves more credit than a lot of people give it. What is Marvel Heroes? It's basically, the simplest way to put it, and I don't like using this, but I will, is Diablo with a Marvel skin. Now, obviously there's tons and tons of differences between Marvel Heroes and Diablo, but I mean, you guys know exactly what I'm talking about when I say Diablo-style game. Torchlight, Path to Exile, things like that, hack and slash, whatever you want to call it. You're going to be running around, killing tons of enemies, and collecting tons of loot. So, why do I like this game so much more than all those others? Well, obviously there's the fact that it's Marvel, and I'm a big fan of Marvel comics, Marvel movies, the Marvel Universe. I mean, I'm not a diehard comic book reader, but there are a few different heroes that I do read all their comics, and they are in the game, fortunately enough for me. So that is one reason why I gravitate towards this game. Another reason is because when I play games like this, Diablo, Path to Exile, whatever, there's usually a very limited amount of classes that you can play. And I really like to switch it up, especially in a game when you're going to be mashing the same buttons over and over and over. It gets very repetitive, and I get burnt out on them real quick. Now, with Marvel Heroes, there are 47 different heroes in the game, 48th actually coming out next week with the two-year anniversary. And that's basically 47 different classes, 47 different ways to kill stuff. Not only that, but there is a lot to do in this game. You know, you have your standard story mode. You have, which you can play on multiple difficulties. You have your bunch of challenges, terminals, and I'm not going to go into detail on what all these things are, but just take my word for it. There is a lot to do in this game. So combine that with the amount of heroes, just a lot of replayability with this game, and that's one of the reasons that I keep coming back to it. Now, I did mention there are 47 heroes in the game. When you start the game up, if you're playing completely free, you don't get to pick any hero you want. Currently, there's a list of heroes that you choose from. You get to play them to level 10, and when you decide which one that you like the most, you can unlock the rest of the levels for that hero. Any hero after that, you will have to either purchase with real money, or you will have to use an in-game currency called Eternity Splinters, which does take some time to accumulate. But it can be done, which is nice, and that's something that wasn't in the game when it first was launched. Speaking of that, when this game first launched, it was pretty bad, I'm not gonna lie. I played it for a little bit and didn't like it, and you know, I kept coming back to it, and it kept getting a little bit better, and now the game is just the original game is just a shell of what the game is now. There is so much to do, so many heroes, just the game is just vastly improved over what it was when it was originally launched. And that's another reason why I'm kind of promoting this game. You know, it is free to play, and a lot of free to play games won't really do a lot to improve their games. That's not Marvel Heroes at all. Marvel Heroes releases a patch every week, whether it's just a little quality of life, maybe a couple bug fixes, but they are often adding major chunks of free content to go along with that. New items, new gear, just all sorts of things that make this game that much better, and it's just continuously getting better as the game goes. In fact, if you look at some reviews on this game, a lot of review sites have re-reviewed this game, and when it first came out, they gave it maybe like a 6 out of 10, something like that. And a lot of them that have re-reviewed it went from like a 6 to a 9. It's just gotten that much better. And I think if you were one of those players that, you know, played on launch and kind of gave up on this game, if you were to come back now, you would be shocked at how much this game has improved, how much more content has been added, just things like that. It has come a long way. Just to touch a little bit more on the free-to-play aspect, because that does make some people nervous about, you know, not getting that much content or maybe being pay-to-win. I already mentioned that the game has a ton of content and they're always releasing new free content. There is no pay-to-win aspect in this game at all. Sure, you can buy experience boost, things like that, but you're not directly competing against other players. So there's really no way pay to win comes into play in this at all. As I said, you can actually play this game completely for free if you want. The heroes, the team up heroes, can both be purchased in-game with in-game currency. A lot of the pets, which really the pets don't do anything other than walk around you, and they have added some bonuses to them, but each pet is the exact same as the other pet in that aspect. So unless you want a specific pet that you have to pay money for, you don't have to do that either. The only thing that you're really going to want to, you know, find yourself wanting to spend money on probably is costumes, which range from anywhere from a few bucks to $12, $13. But even that is just, it's aesthetics. You don't have to do that at all. So anyways, guys, obviously you guys can tell I like this game a lot. I will continue to do a few Marvel videos if I get some interest. It doesn't really matter. You guys know I'm waiting for other games to come out before I really dive back into YouTube too much. But, like I said, if you guys have some interest in Marvel Heroes, I might put up a video or two. Or maybe I'll, if I get enough, maybe I'll actually get into doing more more videos, more regular videos for the game. But if you have any questions, if you want any advice on which hero to buy, what team up hero to buy, anything related to Marvel Heroes, post it in the comment section. I will do my best to keep up and answer any questions that you guys have. So as always, thanks for watching, guys, and I will talk to y'all later.